Travel Tidbits podcast, hosted by the agents of Pineapple Escapes. Join us as we discuss the latest in travel news, destinations, and tips for the savvy traveler. After all, travel makes life sweeter. Hello, and welcome to episode 4 of the Travel Tidbits podcast. I'm Jamie Weidel, travel agent and owner of Pineapple Escapes. This week, we have Kristi Scheer with us, and Kristi and I will be discussing why clients should use a travel agent, and we'll be explaining a little bit more about our business model. So my story about how I know Kristi and how she became an agent is an interesting one from my perspective. I originally started my career in education, and I was a high school teacher at the high school where I graduated from originally. And I actually had both of Kristi's daughters in class. Amy and Emily were both on my yearbook staff, and I was really big into yearbook. It was my passion. It was what I loved to do as a high school student, and I loved connecting with my yearbook girls. Yes, our staff was all girls, and we had so much fun together. And so when Kristi reached out in February of this year, I was like, yeah, I know who you are. I know that you're motivated, driven, and career oriented and would be a great fit. One of my memories of Amy, they went to Disney World over Thanksgiving one year. And I remember being frustrated with Amy because she was gone from my class when I was teaching high school. And now I take my kids out of school all the time, but that's a whole different story. But I knew that Kristi would be a great fit on our team because she was such a great mom to her kids. And she also has a son, Carson, but he was not in high school when I was teaching at the high school, so I didn't have him. But the funny thing is, both Amy and Emily were in my class when I had my son, Beau, 13 years ago. I'm dating myself and Kristi a little bit there. But so they were in my class when I had my son, Beau, and now her daughter, Emily, one of Kristi's grandsons, is also named Beau, but spelled different. And so even though there's probably not a connection, I think it's kind of cute. So anyway, Kristi, thanks for being with us today. And can you tell us a little bit more about yourself and why you decided to take the leap to become a travel agent?
Sure. Thanks, Jamie. I'm really happy to be here. I've been a big podcast fan for years, so I'm really excited to be a part of this new venture for Pineapple Escapes. So a little bit about myself. I live in East Central Illinois in Olney. Some of you may have heard of Olney because we have a pretty unique claim to fame. We're the home of albino squirrels. So let me tell you this, if you have never seen one, they are kind of ugly. They have beady red eyes, but they are rare, so I still love them. But I used to travel extensively for work, and I was amazed at the number of people all over the U.S. who would be like, oh yeah, you're from where they have the white squirrel. So it's kind of crazy to think that people know about that, but for your first pieces of travel advice, if you ever visit Olney, don't hit one with your car because you will be fine. And if you want to see them, go to the city park with a bag of French fries because they are big fans of fries. So there's your first piece of advice right off the bat.
I love that.
Yeah. So back to me. I've been married to my husband, Keith, for 33 years. And as Jamie said, we have three grown children, which they all live in the area, which is really nice. Our daughter, Amy, is married to Alan, and they have a daughter, Quinn, who's one. We have a daughter, Emily, and her husband, Derek, who has the other Beau, who's three, as well as Sadie Jo, who's going to be one January 2nd. I like to joke that she was the one good thing that happened in 2020 before everything went downhill. And then last of all, my son, Carson, and his wife, Kaylee, who got married this year also. So I guess that was another positive thing for 2020. But they, like many people, had to completely change their wedding and reception due to COVID. But, you know, it's okay. In the end, they're still married. So other than my human children, I also have a golden doodle, Aggie. She kind of became my baby after all the kids left home. And I also have two cats, Iris and Takeout, which I know is a very unusual name and is a whole nother story, but it's way too long for a podcast, or it could be a podcast in and of itself. So I guess if anybody really wants to know how he got the name Takeout, they can send a message and I'd be glad to let you know how that all came about.
That sounds like a great idea.
Yeah, it's a very unusual story. So he is just as unusual as his name is. So as far as hobbies, things, of course, I love traveling, or else I wouldn't be doing this. I like to do some crafting, decorating, shopping, as much as my husband dislikes that hobby. I like a good Netflix series, and I also like spending time at the lake and with my family. So that's kind of how I spend my spare time.
So moving forward a little bit, so what made you decide to reach out to me about being a travel agent?
Well, I recently left the corporate world to start working in travel. My bachelor's degree is in nursing and my master's is in community counseling. And I had spent most of my career in management and was most recently working as an executive director for a community mental health center. So a job that over the years has been very stressful generally is working with people with problems, difficulties, things like that. And I just really wanted to make a change and work in something that would just kind of bring some more joy to my life. So I started looking at some options and came across travel as an option. And I thought, well, you know, I love to travel and I love to plan travel. So why not? That might be a great choice. As you know, I messaged you, we talked, I joined your team, I was all gung-ho to go, and then COVID hit.
Yeah.
So talk about a bad timing as far as when to change. But honestly, looking back, it was probably a good thing because it really gave me the time to learn travel, to learn all the ins and outs, so that I could really know the job and probably be a better agent because of it.
I completely agree. I think it's been a hard year for everybody in the travel industry, but having that time to really learn. And I mean, you've been able to go on several trainings, in-person trainings, even during COVID. I think that that has made a big difference. So jumping into our slice of life, talking about, actually, you and I have been on two trainings together relatively recently. Kristi was my roommate when I went to Sandals St. Lucia, and we got to tour both of the resorts there. And then she was also with us on our AEP, where we visited Walt Disney World and Universal. So Kristi, what was your favorite part of those trainings? You can pick one of them. And tell me a little bit about what you've learned and what you can take back to your clients as a result of those training experiences.
I think probably the biggest takeaway, and this was related to our trip to Orlando, the Disney Universal trip. I've always been Team Disney. It seems like people are either Team Universal or Team Disney. But after this training, I really have a new appreciation for Universal. I had been to Universal probably 3 or 4 times, but it had always been just a quick side trip as a part of a bigger Disney trip. So this was the first time I really slowed down, explored Universal, all it had to offer. And I feel like from when I went a few years back to now that they are really upping their game. The resorts, both the parks and the resorts, were beautiful. They had great theming. The rides were awesome. Hagrid's motorbike ride was like nothing I've ridden. It's definitely a must-do for people, I think. So while I still love Disney, I think Universal is a great choice too as a primary vacation site. I think especially if they have kids who maybe think they're too cool now for Disney, they're in that kind of in-between stage, Harry Potter fans, of course, or for boys because Disney has its princesses, but Universal has its Marvel characters, Transformers. I know my grandson, Bo, was very unhappy that I got to see Bumblebee without him. So I think there's a lot to offer there for families.
I completely agree. And I'm glad that you took that away from that trip because I do think it was a lot of fun for all of us to be together. But it was a great way for us to really see the parks and to dive deep into all of those little details that we might not have seen when we were with our families. So I think that that was a lot of positives that came from those trips. Anything you want to add about our St. Lucia trip? What did you think about that one?
I think it was really nice too. And I think the main thing that I learned there is it's really hard to know a location until you go there on site. And that's why we travel a lot is because we want to get that information for our clients. For example, we visited two of the different resorts there. One of them had a lot of walking, had a lot of steps to climb, things like that, that weren't necessarily apparent from looking at their website or from researching on the internet. So that's a huge piece of information that we have for our clients. If we have someone who does have some problems navigating hills or walking and things, we can definitely steer them in the right direction to the resort that's better suited to them.
Absolutely. And I think that that's a good segue right into our At the Course segment for today's podcast. And that's really why to use a travel agent. And today we're going to talk a lot about why we think you should use a travel agent and how we're paid. I think there's a lot of misconceptions out there about how all of this works. And I'll admit, before I became a travel agent myself, I didn't really understand it. You hear, you know, our services are free and you think there has to be a catch, but there really isn't. There are so many benefits to using a travel agent. And we as a team are traveling all the time, even during COVID, to make sure that our clients have the best information possible. And I've said time and time again, both to my agents and to my clients, I have a really hard time selling something that I haven't done personally. And so over the last 6-7 years, I have traveled extensively because every time I have a client ask about something, I end up looking it up and then booking it for myself if I haven't been there previously, because I just feel like I have to have that in-person knowledge to be able to sell it effectively. So Kristi, first of all, why don't you tell me a little bit about your thoughts on using a travel agent and, as a newbie, how this has been for you?
To be honest, I had never used a travel agent before I became one. And now I think, gosh, if at some point I was not a travel agent, there is no way I would travel without one. You know, somebody to do all the research, all the work, all those things for you, and there be no cost to you is just, it is unbelievable. And I think that's a big piece that people don't understand. I think the thing when I joined this team, I found was that none of us do this alone. And I think this is a big selling point to our clients too, is that we're a part of a team and we are constantly talking with each other. If we have clients interested in different destinations, who's been there? What was their experience? What tips do they have? So when you use one of Pineapple Escape's agents, you aren't just getting one of us, you're getting the whole team. And I mean, I would hate to know the number of messages we all do back and forth all day. You know, my husband's like, does your phone ever quit dinging? Because, you know, it's just, it's constant, but it's just a huge benefit for our clients and for us as agents to have that whole team of expertise to fall back on.
I completely agree. I don't know if you saw on the group thread just a little bit ago, Selena posted, so I think this is all I need to know catching up from today. And I made a joke that you can obviously tell when I'm in the office working as the messages are coming hot and heavy. But I think that that is part of the fun of it, is that we do have all of our team to work together and to help each other as we plan trips for our clients, and to have that extensive travel knowledge and background. And between our entire team, we've been so many places. We've been all over the world. And yes, you know, some of us are more Disney people. Some of us are more Universal people. Some of us are more all-inclusive people. But we can take that collective knowledge and use it to work together. I also think that our trainings have a big impact on what we can do for our clients. And we have some awesome trainings coming up in 2021. We're planning a Cancun all-inclusive trip where we're going to travel to Cancun and tour numerous resorts. We're planning a Disneyland trip. Hopefully COVID is long past and it's reopened by then. And we also have a Disney Cruise Line cruise plan. Kristi and I will also be going, hopefully, fingers crossed, if cruises are open by then, on a trip in April on a Royal Caribbean ship. So we have tons of trainings planned for our agents to help them to help their clients then make the best choice for their family. I was on a meeting this morning and she was saying, you know, it's just so overwhelming when you go to plan a vacation. And I was like, yes. And that's why you use a travel agent, someone who can ask those qualifying questions and narrow down all of the information that's out there. It's great to say, I want to go on vacation. But if you don't know where you want to go, you don't know how you want to handle it, those are questions that a travel agent can ask that can narrow it down and help you really focus on what would be the best for your family. Kristi, one of the things I did want to ask you about is, how have your hold times been? What is your thought on how that impacts how we serve our clients?
Hold times have varied a lot. Some I've been on as long as 2 hours on hold, and that's really not that unusual. I think, especially as we navigate through COVID, some of these travel companies and things that we use have reduced the number of people they have answering phones and so forth. So those numbers have gone up even more. Plus, as people are changing and shifting around their travel, they've got a large volume too. So just the amount of time that a travel agent can save you spending on hold is huge, because it really has been a factor.
I agree. And my husband jokes that I spend half my day on hold half the time. But some of our vendors, especially when something new is dropped, when promos are released, Disney for one, I know I've been on hold for over 5 hours before on the day that a promo drops. Wouldn't you rather, as a client, have your travel agent on hold, taking care of that, watching for discounts and doing all of that? And I think it really does, as a client, save you time and money, because your agent is monitoring for discounts, watching for when those promos drop, and is the one waiting on hold when they drop to ensure that you obtain those discounts. And I think that that is a very important service that we offer.
Definitely. I would say on that time, also as travel agents, a lot of the different vendors, we have a different number. And so the volume is a little bit less. So I'm going to guess if it's an individual like on hold with Disney, they're probably going to be waiting even longer than those hold times that we are. And just to kind of reinforce what you said, you know, Disney put out some special rates for rooms. So I had a couple of clients I was able to get on and get their booking changed to get them that reduced rate. So that's a huge service we have too, is just watching and making sure that we take advantage of those things for our clients.
Another thing I wanted to hit on while we're talking about Disney is dining and fast passes. So one of the services that we offer for our clients is we make their dining reservations. Before COVID, that was 180 days out at 5 a.m. Central Time. So I was used to setting my alarm early for that. And now it's actually changed to 60 days out. I'm kind of hoping that sticks, but we'll see what happens. And then fast passes were previously 60 days out for clients who are staying on site. Fast passes currently aren't a thing due to COVID, but we'll see what happens with that if they come back or what happens. But that's another awesome service that we offer for our clients. We work with them to narrow down what dining options would be best for their family, what fast passes we recommend and would be best for them. And then we make those reservations for them. Also, if the dining isn't available, we do offer a dining watch service so we can watch and monitor to wait for that dining to open up. And typically I do have good success with that, but it's obviously not something we can guarantee. But we do our best to help our clients to make sure that they get the reservations that they want and that are the best suited for them.
Yeah, to go along with that, I know just this week I did some dining reservations for someone, and while it might seem, that would be pretty easy to go online and do those, this was a large party taking multiple tables. So it wasn't something that you could easily go on to My Disney Experience and do. It was a matter of calling and working with them through finding enough tables for the whole group at a different location. So again, just a way that we're better able to serve. And so you're not the one who's on hold waiting to get those reservations made.
Some of those big family group trips are some of my favorite to plan, because you can work together with them to figure it all out. But then the planning part is a lot of fun, I think, to kind of piece all the different things together. We do book all those extras for you. And that's not only Disney. That's at Universal. If you need dining reservations, that's at All Inclusives. We make sure that all of the details are covered. It doesn't matter where you're going. If you're going to Vegas, if you're going to Seattle, if you're going to New York, we have travel tip sheets with extras and different tips for restaurants and things to do for all of the different places that you're going to be visiting. And we've worked together as a team to make those tip sheets and special booklets for things like Disney, Universal, cruises, so that we have those little extras for you as part of your itinerary. All of our agents also provide an e-package with travel documents, a personalized itinerary, tips and tricks, and that itinerary is customized for each client based on the destination, based on their family type, based on if it's a couple's trip, what are they doing, what do they like. We customize all of those things for our clients. We also throw in a little bit of quote-unquote extra pixie dust, and this varies based on the booking. And it can be anything from some cake pops delivered to your Walt Disney World resort to maybe a large gift basket for your honeymoon in Hawaii. But there's always something special that we add for your bookings. So I think that really the most important thing about our agency, besides the fact that we're an awesome team and all work together, is that we are real people and we care about you. We care about your trip. We're not just a booking engine. It's not just a website. If you have a problem, there is a real person that you can get a hold of that cares about you and cares about your trip. And I think that that alone makes it worthwhile. However, it's also free. So, Kristi, tell me a little bit about what it means when we say our services are free.
Well, when we say they're free, it really does mean free. What happens is there is a small commission that's paid to us by whoever we're booking with. So, for example, if we are booking you for a night at a Marriott hotel, we can get you the same price as if you booked yourself through Marriott or went through one of the travel websites for that. Our commission is paid to us by who we book with, for example, Marriott in this case. So there is a small commission that if you didn't use us, they would retain themselves. So it's not costing you anything. However, it does support our small business because your bookings are how we make our living. So while we love to provide advice and help people and plan vacations, the important part for us is that you allow us to also make those bookings for you because that is how we're paid.
Yes, absolutely. And I think that there's like misconception out there that and there are travel agents that charge fees. We are not one of them. And there are travel agents that earn a salary of sorts. That is not how our agency works. So I'm actually the agency owner, and then all of the other agents are independent contractors. So all of our income is based on commission. So if you talk to us but then don't book, we don't earn anything. So it's just lost time, lost money. However, if you do book with us, it should match exactly what you can find online. So if you're going to Marriott.com, we can book that exact same Marriott.com room for the exact same price, but we would get a kickback. And we provide all of these services that we've just talked about on top of that booking. So I don't understand why people don't use a travel agent, honestly. And I did use a travel agent before I was one, and it was actually my travel agent who drew me into the business. She was one of my college friends. But I just find it bizarre that people don't do this. But I think a lot of it is just a misconception and not understanding how it works, how we're paid, and what services we provide. Any other thoughts?
Jamie, something else that might play into that. Some people may feel like if I use a travel agent, I'm handing over control of my whole vacation. And that's definitely not the case. I mean, we might have an individual who says, here's where I want to go, here's when, and you just run with it and book it. But there's varying degrees. You know, we have some people who very definitely say, I want to go here, I want to do this, this, and this, exactly lay it out for us. And we're happy to book those. We're happy to book those who say, do whatever you want. So you have the ability to be as involved or as uninvolved as you want to be in your travel planning. You know, we make this personal to you to fit what you would like. So don't feel like if I use a travel agent, I don't get to make the decisions, because you definitely do. Our goal is to try to make it as easy for you to make those decisions. So with so many resources out there, you know, today with the internet, you can be bombarded with lots of choices. So when we talk to you, we try to drill down on what you would really like to do, research, find those best options for you, and then present those to you so that you can decide what you would like to do.
Excellent point. Yes, I completely agree. And I have had some Disney clients even who want to make their own dining and fast passes. So we will still talk about, you know, what dining they're going to pick, what fast passes they're going to pick, but then they do it on their own. And I'm fine with that. I mean, it's no sweat off my back if there are things that you want to do on your own. Or if you send me, here's my itinerary, please book this. Sure. Yes, I'll do that. No problem. I mean, it makes it very easy on our part, but we're also here for those who aren't as organized and don't have it all mapped out, don't know exactly what they want. And we're here to advise them. But if you do know what you want, we can still help you. And it's still the same cost. And you still have someone who has your back, who's a real person and not just a random website with an 800 number.
Let's face it, we all have enough stress in our lives. We don't need vacation planning to add to that. So we're kind of like a personal assistant that you get for free. So that's kind of cool to think about. You have that somebody to do all this work for you. And you just get to say yes, no, and kind of go through those kind of things. So it's kind of a treat for yourself to have, I think, to use a travel agent.
Right. And with no cost. I mean, right. You just hate it. I completely agree. Obviously, I completely agree. Let's go ahead and jump into our last segment of the day, our Crushed It segment. Kristi, this is all you. This is one of your travel favorites that you recommended, a phone holder for on the plane. Tell us about this.
Yes. So I came across this on Amazon, and I know I have one ordered for myself because, as you notice, when you're on a plane, people are either trying to hold their phone and watch the movie, or they're trying to prop it up on that slick tray and it just keeps sliding down and won't set up, or they're trying to juggle their drink and their phone and things like that. So this is a handy little phone holder that will clip to the tray when it's in the upright position, or it can also be set up into like a tripod that it can set on the table, or you can use it at home on your desk or wherever. And then it also can also clamp onto your handle on your suitcase. So if you're sitting in the airport, you can simply click it on your carry-on bag and you can watch it there and have your hands free to do whatever. So just a really handy thing for when you travel, and you can also use it at home.
Awesome. Well, we will have a link to this in our show notes. And then, Kristi, how many pineapple rings would you rate this for travel? Or you haven't actually gotten yours yet. So I guess
I haven't actually gotten mine, but I have really high hopes. This is going to be a 4 or 5.
Awesome. Well, we'll have to follow up on that. Maybe the next episode that you're on, we'll talk about it a little bit more.
Okay.
Anyway, Kristi, thanks for joining us today as we discuss the importance of utilizing a travel agent and how we can help travel make your life sweeter. You can find all of our Pineapple Escapes agents on the web at www.pineappleescapes.com. Our site includes links to all of our Travel Tidbits episodes, plus information about all of our agents and links for our social media. We'd love to have you join our community. Bye, guys. We hope you've enjoyed today's episode of the Travel Tidbits podcast hosted by Pineapple Escapes. Travel makes life sweeter. Let the experts help you plan a vacation with lasting memories. We'd love to help you plan your next vacation and have you join our community. You can find us on the web at www.pineappleescapes.com and on Facebook and Instagram at Pineapple Escapes.